We're here at Kiel Golf Centre with TG Test Pro Neil Wayne. We're talking about forged irons. Over the last 3 months, a number of the top brands have all launched forged irons, so TaylorMade, Mizuno, Srixon and Honma. And we've already done previous tests on the Mizuno and TaylorMade, but now felt like the perfect opportunity to put all the new models into a single test to see if we can help you decide which is the best for your game. We've already done previous videos on the TaylorMade and Mizuno and told you plenty about them. So we'll leave a link in the description of this video if you want to see those. But let's get started by telling you what you need to know about the Honma and Srixons. Honma TR20, there's three different models, Neil. Just tell us a little bit about them.
Yeah, and a great idea from what I feel like they've got all aspects covered here for every level of golfer. So starting with the muscle back, traditional loft.
And it's one piece forged.
One piece forged. I dare say that you're gonna see a little bit less forgiveness in there.
And you've got lots of loft on it as well.
Correct. Back to, like I say, traditional loft. Then we've got into the player iron, a little bit stronger in loft. Again, you've got the one piece forged in there as well. Dare say you're gonna obviously pick up a little bit more distance on this over the previous due to the loft.
Okay, and probably just worthwhile to say that only 10% of tour pros would play this style of iron. A lot more swing towards this style, yes?
And that speaks volumes, doesn't it, really? So be careful when you're choosing your, remember what you put on the line when you do go for the muscle back iron. And then the player's distance iron finally, which you've got, still got quite a nice compact head, but you've got very strong loft and then the fast face in there, haven't you, Simon?
Great, okay, and probably just worthwhile pointing out that Justin Rose has had a lot of input into the B model, even though he's not a Honma staff player anymore. But Sergio Garcia has also been spotted out on tour playing them, so they are aimed at a very elite golfer. Right, let's have a look at the Srixon ZX irons.
So again, two categories, opposed to the three from the Honma. Firstly, the player iron. The thing that strikes me the most, Simon, straight away is generally you see a player iron at around about 34 mark loft-wise. This is 32, so a little bit stronger. One thing I do notice, though, is those razor-sharp lines on there really are distinct, do you know what I mean? Quite a clean look to it.
It's a blade style,
yeah,
but with a tall cavity. That's what Srixon says.
Yeah,
so you get your likes of your Graham McDowells, your Keegan Bradleys, your Shane Lowry.
Yeah, so
it plays them.
Well, that speaks volumes, doesn't it, guys, at that level that are using it. So popping back to this, and you can see that the good thing is it, like I've mentioned before, it's quite a compact looking head. It's not really small, so it's not off-putting, but it's also not on the flip side where it's big and looks like really forgiving. Do you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Right, onto the ZX5, the player's distance iron. So obviously, now we're looking at a little bit more stronger in loft, which is a theme through most brands, isn't it, really? I'm going to expect a little bit more distance for it to be hotter, improve a little bit of ball speed, and hopefully on a miss it, still maintain decent distances. Another thing what I like about the Simon, like the Honma that I've that we've just discussed previously, is you can buy them individually. So you can make your perfect combination set. That's a great asset to have. Long irons in this, short irons in this. If you struggle with a long iron ball striking wise, this would be a great option to go to. I really like the way, or you can go right the way through with either. You don't have to make the combination, but the choice is there.
Cool. And just one last thing as well, that Srixon say that they've got a mainframe face on the ZX 5 iron. And basically what they've done is that they've used artificial intelligence to be able to design that face. So it's really thin, really fast. And that's a pretty sort of explosive combination, isn't it? Right, that's loads of talking. Let's get out there and start hitting, Neil. Right, Neil, you've hit quite a few shots there with the Honma and the Srixon. Just give us a little bit of initial feedback.
Firstly, starting with this Srixon, the ZX7, really, really nice looking club, Simon. I love the sharp lines and that sits like dead square, it's flush. Quite a small top line as well on the ZX7, which is something that I like the look of it at address. And I've just noticed there, Simon, like when I've just been like having a closer look, when I look down the line of the grooves there, you can see that they're like, can you see on the angle that you're at there?
Laser etching.
I'm pretty certain that surely is going to give a little bit of an advantage on not having that in there, that technology, whether it be get rid of a little bit of debris or moisture when you're in the semi-rough, just to try and give you that little bit extra, little bit of control, really.
Cool. Okay, and the Honmas? You were very, very keen on the P, weren't you?
Yeah, what's impressed me the most is how hot it feels for something that looks so compact.
Yeah, for a fast face as well, it seemed to peak it out really high and drop down very steeply.
Normally you would relate fast face, strong aloft with like lower ball flight, uncontrollable, but I dare say looking at it off the naked eye with the TR20P, like you've just said, I seem to be hitting the peak height, steep descent angle, but it looks like it's getting out there as well. There's some distance on it, definitely.
Right, we've got loads more testing to crack on and do. Once we've done it and crunched the numbers, we'll see you back at the Wall of Wisdom. Just before we have a look at the data, let's first off just have a look at the different construction methods behind all of these irons, because they're all slightly different, Neil, and they offer something different.
Certainly do. I mean, when you get the whole head there that's forged, obviously you tend to get that link with your muscle back kind of irons. Yeah. And you go to the whole head forged with a little bit of tungsten weighting.
Yeah, some have the tungsten weighting, some don't.
Correct.
But that's your player's irons.
Yeah.
So you've got your muscle back blades, you've got your player's irons.
And then generally the faster face models and versions, now you're generally seeing just a forged face, aren't you? So you've got a cast body, generally hollowed, and the forged face in there to give it a little bit better feel, really.
Yeah, so sometimes it can be a cavity back, sometimes it's hollow bodied. Essentially the face is always forged, and that's what gives you the forged feel and the forged sound. Okay, let's move on. Let's have a look at five iron performance. We don't usually show the data for the long irons that we hit when we test each of the products, Neil. And it just feels right in this particular test for us to show you how all the five irons compared for the irons that we have the five iron in. And it makes for some pretty interesting reading.
Certainly does. Firstly, I want to mention, Sam, to the guys that please pay attention when you're considering your long irons. If you're striking a 7-iron nicely and it's performing, it's hitting the correct numbers, there's nothing there to say and indicate that it's going to be doing the same thing with
your
long irons.
Especially if you're using players' irons,
Especially if, like you've said before, the players' irons, especially your smaller heads, do you know what I mean? Less forgiveness, and you'll see it even more in the long irons when you get less loft in the hands, I promise you.
Okay, so we've come up with this as a comparison between the players' irons and the players' distance irons in each of the different categories here. Just talk us through what we found.
Yeah, so the first thing that I want to pick up, and the guys will see the data, is how well the P770 did over the P7MC. You can see there the numbers that you generally see, we'd want to find a little bit more ball speed, wouldn't we? You generally relate it to, because of the more ball speed, hence the stronger loft, those two link, but then you'd think that spin would be down, sometimes a little bit less descent angle, but it's not always the case. I mean, this is a perfect example. All I've done there is gained ball speed, gained a little bit in backspin, same peak height, which is perfect, gained actually descent angle, and got exactly the same carry. So why on earth would I carry, if I was to use TaylorMade, why would I carry the P7MC over the 770 long iron? Just wouldn't.
Absolutely. And just as a casing point, at the USPGA, it was a big story that Rory McIlroy had a new set of irons in his bag, which were the MB irons. But what was missed by a lot of people was that Tommy Fleetwood put the P770 long irons in his bag, and he obviously realises that he gets a little bit more punch, a little bit more kick out of those long irons. And now, if you've been able to choose, mix and match the sets, it's really, really important that you get this absolutely right for your own game. Switch where you choose where you switch over between short irons and long irons into the players' distance models, if that is what you need. And just talk us through the Honma a little bit as well, because that was very interesting.
Yeah, it was. Again, so you've got the V versus the P, Simon. The ball speed, the increase there is huge, isn't it? 4.9%.
It's stronger loft, isn't it?
Yeah, so you'd expect, like I said, you're going to expect to see that. But obviously, the P, again, there, drop off in the backspin, which, like I said, we would expect. That's why I was so impressed with the 770, to maintain that spin. Yeah. But this is the thing.
Higher.
Yeah, I'm still getting to the peak height. So get you, the guys that are linking things with like fast face, less loft, goes low. It's not the case, is it? Wouldn't get more of a peak height if it was going low.
Yeah. And it flies higher and it comes in at a steeper descent angle
exactly.
as well.
Exactly. Therefore, surely it's going to land softer into the greens. This is why. Please get switched on to using a bit more of a hotter faced long iron, because they really do work. You've got to test them, haven't they, Simon? Definitely. Don't just match all your clubs up without trying them. Do you know what I mean?
Okay, let's move on and let's have a look at the Mizuno irons and how they break down. We've already had lots and lots of questions about which Mizuno iron suits a particular type of golfer. So we thought this slide would really help you choose which might suit you. And now this is information that's come direct from the iron selector on Mizuno's website. Just talk us through it, Neil, because it's quite interesting, yeah?
I think it's really clever what Mizuno have done here. Looking at you can get your best match done through your handicap, which sometimes we know you can't relate to somebody, I don't know, could be a fantastic ball striker and a really poor with the short irons, whatever. But it's a brief guide, and I think it's really good. You've got your best match with a little bit more forgiveness, then you're more workable. The standout performers for me that guys should be looking at in this Mizuno range would be the JPX 91 Forged and the MP20 HMB. Those would be the two that would strike me, that you could go to the majority of the handicap section there, Simon.
Cool, and if your handicap is between 5 and 14, you have got those two irons to choose from, because depending on what you want over here, you can get a more forgiving or more workable model. I think what really stands out to me personally is that we've had loads of questions about the JPX 91 Forged against the HMB. How do I decide? Well, this does it on handicap, but what is really important is that the HMB is a little bit less forgiving compared to the JPX 91 Forged. So just bear that in mind when you're making your choice. Right, let's move on to the final slide, Neil. Let's look at all of the data for all of the irons that we've tested. Right, the bit that everybody loves to hate, Neil. all of the data, just to make it clear, everybody, we've created all of this data using a Foresight GC2, and we've just used the SkyTrack ball flights just to be able to show you where some shots have gone. Okay, Neil, talk us through it. Where are we?
Yeah, so let's start with your muscle backs, okay? The huge, huge plus side that you're gonna find with the muscle back iron, for me personally, is you will maintain decent spin. Fairly traditional loft, around the 34 degrees. You can, for a 7-iron, you're gonna relate that to half decent spin numbers. The downside is you're putting yourself on the back foot with a slight miss. Do you know what I mean? You have heavy drop-offs in ball speed and carrying up. Correct, no forgiveness there. For me, guys need to be looking down this sort of area here. Your player's iron and your player's distance iron. Now, this is the perfect opportunity for the guys to get the setup and the makeup right for you,
there's never been a more perfect opportunity,
exactly.
Because they are all available as individuals or as mix and match.
Correct.
Sets.
And if you can, I know it can be difficult, but if you can go and try a few of the long irons in different brands, then please do so, because you'll be amazed what you can do with the 7-iron. You might not be able to do with the 5-iron. We've tested it. The proof's in the pudding. Do you know what I mean? A slight miss in a 5-iron with some of the players' iron and some of the muscle back irons, I was massively, massively punished with that, as you can remember, Simon. Whereas your players' distance iron, still maintaining decent peak height, decent descent angle. I'm improving on ball speed. You're going to get a little bit less spin sometimes. Yes, don't get me wrong. And people try and link that sometimes to lower ball flights, but it's not necessarily the case.
Okay, so before I ask you for your standout models, let me just tell you why we haven't got any data down here at the bottom for the Srixon ZX5. Basically, we created all of this data a number of weeks ago, and Srixon weren't able to let us have the 5 to include in that test session. But we've been able to hit it today whilst we've been here. And what we've basically seen, compared to the Srixon ZX7 model, is that you get about 2 miles an hour more ball speed You get the same spin, 9% higher, which is absolutely brilliant. A little fraction steeper descent angle, so about 1 degree steeper, and an extra 4 yards of carry. You know, so we haven't included that on there because we don't like testing over different days, Neil. But no. With all that said, what are your standout models from?
Oh, it's difficult one. Firstly, I did like the look of both Srixons, especially in terms of the long irons. The ZX5 looked like there was a bit more forgiveness there. It looked a bit, but it's not over chunky or big. Mm-hmm. But the two in terms of performance for me would be the JPX 91 Forged, mm-hmm, and the TaylorMade P770. Those would be the two that have really shone for me in terms of looks and performance. Because generally, if you like the look of something, you tend to hit it better as well, don't you?
Cool. And they would probably be open to the widest possible audience of the models that we've tested, along with the Honma P as well.
Yeah, the Honma P, and maybe, like when you looked at the Mizuno guide, don't overlook the HMB as well. That would be an iron that's definitely worth looking at.
If you like the video, hit the like and subscribe button. And if you've got any comments or questions, leave them below. We promise to answer every single sensible one. We'll see you next time.